Sayyidina Abu al-Harith Bunani rahmatullahi alayhi says, I joined them. And after a short while later, we approached a group of people sitting in a circle. There was an old man amongst them who looked as if he was their chief. He showed me great esteem and said, with your permission, should we listen to some singing? I granted permission. Two of the men began to sing a romantic and illicit song with a beautiful voice, which intoxicated the listeners, who then began to shout out words of praise and admiration. I stood up shocked, thinking to myself, how could such pious-looking people could be thrilled by such songs of beauty and love instead of songs of Tawheed and Marifa and Hamd and Naad of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu salam? All of a sudden the old man said, oh Shaykh, Ya Sayyidi, let me tell you who I am. I am Shaitan and these are my children. There are two benefits that I reap by making people sit in gatherings full of dancing and singing. Number one, I had a lofty status, but then I was banished, and ever since I was banished, I have been living in grief. So I use music to relieve myself from my worries. And number two, I use music to trick people into obeying their immoral desires and committing even more sins. He left immediately. Madani, Islamic. The previous story teaches us that music is an intoxicant that makes its listeners forget everything in the world. It also teaches us that music incites you to commit sin, to commit guna. It kindles fire of lust in the heart and strips a man of shame. Sayyidina Allama Jalaluddin Suyuti Ash-Shafi Rahmatullahi Ta'ala says, keep away from music because it incites feelings of lust. It destroys shame and it is like wine. It intoxicates. Tubu ilallah, astaghfirullah. Those of you who watch films, listen to music, and show interest in games and amusements should make tawbah to Allah Azza wa Jal immediately. As Allah Azza wa Jal says in the 6th verse of Surah Luqman, Ala Hazrat radiallahu ta'ala narrates this verse as such, and some people buy words of play in order to mislead from Allah Azza wa Jal's path without knowledge, and to make it an article of mockery for them is a disgraceful punishment. Tubu ilallah, astaghfirullah. My dear Islamic brethren and Islamic sisters, our Pyare Aka sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has said, songs and anything that makes you neglect virtuous acts, it makes hypocrisy grow in the heart the way water makes greenery grow. And I swear by him, Allah Azza wa Jal, in whose hand is my life, indeed the Quran and the remembrance of Allah Azza wa Jal makes iman grow in the heart the way water makes grass grow. Subhanallah. Pyare Aka sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam said, if someone raises his voice with singing, Allah Azza wa Jal appoints two shayateen to accompany him. They sit on each of his shoulders, one on the right and one on the left, and both of them kick him with their feet until he stops singing. Tubu ilallah, astaghfirullah. Sayyidina Dahak radiallahu anhu states, singing spoils the heart and disappoints Allah Azza wa Jal. Sayyidina Anas radiallahu anhu says, that our Pyare Aka Madine wale Mustafa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam has mentioned that if anyone sits near a singer and listens to him, Allah Azza wa Jal will pour melted lead into his ears on the day of Qiyamah. Tubu ilallah, astaghfirullah. My dear Islamic brothers and Islamic sisters, there is no doubt that playing music is a guna. It is haram and will lead to the fire of Jahannam. If others are listening, then the one playing will not only be responsible for his own guna, but the sin of all those who are listening too will be in his account. For instance, if music is being played in a hotel or in a shop or in a bus and 50 people are listening, then each and every listener is sinning, he's making guna. But the one playing the cassette or the CD is not only being burdened with his own guna, but he is being burdened with the sins of 50 listeners too. Tubu ilallah, astaghfirullah. Those of you who own music shops and film centers should reflect on the consequences of selling just one cassette or CD. How many times just that one cassette will be listened to? By how many people? Only Allah and His beloved Rasul alayhi salam knows best. And not only to mention how many times that one cassette will be recorded or CD will be recorded and passed on to other Islamic brothers and Islamic sisters. Selling these cassettes and CDs may seem like an ordinary job, but in actual fact, it is full of piles and piles and piles of guna. Unfortunately, the fear of Allah Azza wa Jal is departing from our hearts. Just think for a second, as to how much our Pyare Aqa sallallahu ta'ala wa sallam hates music. It is narrated, Sayyidina Nafi radiallahu ta'ala says that once I was walking with Sayyidina Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu, when we heard him sound of music, Sayyidina Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu ta'ala anhu put his fingers in his ears and walked away. He walked away from the music. When he was far away, Sayyidina Nafi radiallahu ta'ala anhu asked, Oh Nafi, can you hear anything? He replied, no. And then he took his fingers out of his ears and said, once I was with the Messenger of Allah Azza wa Jalla wa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, and he heard the sound of a flute being played, and Pyare Aqa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he also, just what I have done, that put my hand into my ears in order not to hear the music. My dear Islamic brother. So you see how intensely Sayyidina Abdullah bin Umar radiallahu anhu hated music, and how he put his fingers in his ears on hearing the music. Not only that, he walked away from the direction of the music. These days, even if someone does hate music, he is still deprived of following the luminous sunnah of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam. In fact, if he sat in a hotel or a shop or a wedding hall where music is being played and films are being shown on the TV screen, he will not even get up and leave. Instead, he will stay there. He will be seated there. Just think for a second, for a moment, think for a second. Sayyidina Abdullah bin Abbas radiallahu ta'ala narrates that Pyare Aqa sallallahu ta'ala wasallam said, I have been commanded to break the drums and the flutes. Unfortunately, Muslims who claim to be the devoted slaves of the last messenger of Allah Azza wa Jalla wa sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam, they are passionately fond of drums and flutes. They cannot even get married without having the drums being beaten. Listening to music is one thing. The beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam hated even the existence of musical instruments. Unfortunately, despite claiming to be the slaves and the passionate devotees of the beloved Rasul alayhi salatu wasalam, Muslims of today own music centers in almost every street. In fact, we have turned our homes into music centers. Is there any shop today which does not play music? Is there any restaurant today that does not provide its customers with the facility to watch TV or play music? Is there any house that does not have a satellite dish or a TV antenna fixed to it? What has happened to you, oh the lovers of Muhammad sallallahu ta'ala alayhi wa sallam? The noise of films, dramas and music can be heard everywhere. Every Muslim child is seen flicking his arms and legs, dancing away to the beats of the drums. My dear Islamic brothers and Islamic sisters, let me tell you of a dreadful story so that you can take heed from it. A Pakistani newspaper dated the 20th of February 1999 published the following piece of news. Yesterday night, Lahore experienced severe winds and rainfall, after which there was intense